But there's a very modern experiment done in West London area. It's a really up-to-date operation. In the West London area, there are 100 traffic signals, 100 sets of traffic signals, and they're all linked to a computer in New Scotland Yard. Now, the job of this computer is to keep the traffic flowing. Here at the control room in New Scotland Yard, information is being continually received on the movement of traffic in the streets of West London. On this map, each set of traffic lights is shown as a triangle and is numbered. When the lights turn green, the triangle turns green. Other lights on the map show the length of traffic queues at each junction. Some of the road junctions are watched by television cameras. Now, this enables the policeman on duty in the control room actually to see what the traffic is doing there. He can even operate the cameras by remote control. By moving a lever, the camera can be made to swing to another position. For a closer look, the picture can be switched to a larger screen. Below it is a diagram of the junction. Hello, what's happened here? Fortunately, nothing serious. If it had been serious, the policeman on duty would have sent a mobile patrol to deal with any trouble and change the traffic lights. Now, see those marks on the road? Well, under them, buried in the road, are the detectors. These pass information about traffic queues to the computer. So, the sets of traffic lights are shown on the map, like these at a junction near the Albert Hall. The same junction is watched by television cameras. There's another view of the same junction. Well, we decided to go out and have a look for the television cameras. We found the junction with the Albert Hall in the background that we'd seen in the control room. We looked around, and there, above the traffic, we saw the camera. Now, this camera is linked to the control room at New Scotland Yard. Well, by crossing the road, we could see what the camera was looking at. There we are. It was looking at the traffic lights and the oncoming traffic. We followed the traffic along, and there was the camera. Now remember, the position of the camera can be altered to look the other way. But at this junction, there were two cameras. There's the other one. Now, this camera was pointing in the opposite direction. And it was looking at the traffic coming the other way. So, the computer keeps the traffic moving by controlling the traffic lights. But should the traffic come to an unexpected standstill and the computer is unable to deal with the situation, then an alarm is given. The policemen on duty investigate the cause of the trouble. It may be due to an accident or a breakdown. Once the problem has been discovered, then a radio call is sent out and mobile police go to the spot to get the traffic moving again.